and welcome.
That's not funny. Hit it. Oh, and the world's going crazy.
Stop, drop, and suck.
We've got no time for bullshit.
Stop, drop, and suck. With Ava, RJ, and B-Rock. It's Stop. Stop, drop, and talk.
Nothing to say.
Stop, drop, and talk.
Yeah, what's up, guys?
What's up, Eva? What's up, Vera?
Season finale.
It's the season final, and we already lost Eva. And
oh,
she's gone.
We'll get her back.
And she's gone. She's we'll so excited. Back. She just can't move. Ah, she's back. Hey, you're going to steal everybody. Well, hey, welcome to Stop, Drop, and Talk. This is the season finale. This is the last episode of season one. I can't believe we've gotten to this point. Has it been 10 weeks already?
It has.
Gosh,
like 2.5 months we've been doing this.
Where did the time go? That's what I want to know.
Where did time come from?
We've had so much fun. We've learned so much.
What is like time?
We've learned so much from each other, and we've also learned a lot of what not to do.
Right.
So, you know, negative reinforcement.
Let's be real.
more of that. I'm excited because we got Tyler from Theory of a Deadman. Sorry, Theory. Tyler Theory. From Theory.
There's a name change in there somewhere.
I'm really curious about that.
I think we'll get into that.
Look at that hair.
Oh, man. Dude, that is a handsome man. Oh, my
Ace
God.
Ace Ventura, man. He's Ace Ventura, but like a rock star.
Really
I don't
handsome.
Know if he would take that as a compliment. Maybe he would.
I don't see Ace Ventura. I see like the Canadian.
He's like the hot girl in the movie.
He could probably date Courtney Cox. I don't know.
Would anybody want to date her now? Have you seen it? Never mind. I'll shut up.
You see? This is why we have Eva around to keep us up to date with what's going on and all the fucked up things that are happening.
It's not Monica Geller anymore. I'll put it that way.
Uh-oh. Well, you want to get into it? Do you want to talk about it?
No, I don't.
All right. You know what? People will have to Google that for themselves, and I'm
yes.
Me included.
So last week we had a super awesome fun show. We had AJ and Jeremy Popoff from Lit on. That was really nice.
In the front yard.
You know, I don't know if I mentioned this last week, but I remember like when we started out playing in local Pennsylvania, in like central Pennsylvania, every single cover band played that song. And I heard that song almost every single night we go, like multi-band gigs. You couldn't escape that song.
Well, South Dakota's 10 years behind the rest of the country. So that's what Brock and I are dealing with that.
That song was an anthem also. So
for sure.
It was an anthem. I think I appreciate it more now than I did back then. And those guys are great.
To have on. Way fun guests to have on. I look forward to it. And I believe when we get to Nashville, when B-Rock and I get to Nashville, we are supposed to go do tequila shots at Jeremy's house since he's your neighbor.
Tequila shots, I'm in.
You have some really cool neighbors, dude. What's your other neighbor?
I know. I live right near Jeremy from Lid. I live right next door to Vanessa Carlton, you know? So, you know, when I'm making my way downtown, I'm literally making my way downtown. There's another song we couldn't escape when we were kids. Like, that song was everywhere.
Speaking of...
And the funny thing is, when I met Vanessa Carlton, is that, like, the whole time in my mind, because when I meet somebody new, I'm thinking, like, oh, God, I don't want, like, someone who's a fan to, like, know where I live. So I'm just like, please don't recognize me. Please don't recognize me. And the whole time, she's probably thinking the same thing. Like, please don't recognize me. Don't be a fan, you know? So we have that in common.
Speaking of celebrities...
Oh.
It's somebody's birthday today. That's... pretty important.
Not John Goodman's.
Tom Cruise, right?
What?
Look at that. Happy birthday, Tom.
Oh, he loves Scientology.
Oh my God.
He loves it. I don't think he's into Scientology anymore, is he?
100%.
Still, really?
He's still, yes.
He's still hanging on.
Allegedly, that's why Katie Holmes left him.
Oh.
Yeah.
Source that's subject. I think if we ever have him on a podcast, don't bring that up.
Okay, yeah.
He won't be couch jumping on our show. Happy birthday to Maverick, I guess, is what we can call him, because there's another Top Gun movie. Did it already come out?
It did come out, yeah.
Did it come out?
Yeah, it was like May of 2020.
What?
So yeah. It bombed? Well,
you can't really go see it in theaters at that point. But
can you stream it though?
A lot of movies are going straight to Netflix now.
Yeah, have any of you guys seen that that movie with Pete Davidson, the King of Staten Island or whatever?
No, but I want to. It looks good because it's based on his life.
Yeah, it's based on his life, and like there was like, you know, Judd Apatow's involved, and there's like a star-studded cast, you know, Bill Burr and all these people, and it's a shame. I think he said in interviews that they were anticipating this big theatrical release, but because of the quarantine, they ended up just soft releasing it digitally, and so it's kind of a bummer. But still, I mean, it got a lot of buzz. A lot of people know about it. So
that guy just gets like one kick in the nuts after the other.
Oh my god!
I'll have to check it out because I love Judd Apatow so much.
Me too. Let's get him on the show.
Everything he does is awesome, but like poor Pete Davidson, like gets the tattoo for Ariana Grande, like the bunny ears, and then they break up. Oh. And he covers it up, and then he does like a stand up. And if you watch the stand up, like I thought it was kind of funny. It was awkward.
I haven't yet, but I heard it's like really dark.
It's dark humored. It's a little awkward, but like not that many people laugh at him. Like the whatever Amy Schumer did that was like the leather special that was not fucking funny. In fact, I don't think Amy Schumer's that funny. I'm going to put it out there. I just don't think she's great. It was kind of like that. And then on top of all of that, he comes out with this movie, King of Staten Island, and COVID happens.
Oh, yeah.
Of course, yeah.
Literally one kick in the nuts after the other for this poor guy.
Oh, man.
No, that's hard.
Yeah, that hurts. Also, it's 4th of July tomorrow, and you guys are really close to Mount Rushmore, so how's everything going over there?
Well,
I heard it's a little bit chaotic.
Before we get into that, it's time to transition into a little segment.
Oh, is it time?
It's time.
It's time.
It's time.
Time for what?
Some fucks give it!
Oh, okay, there we go.
Some people got many and others have none. We're all going crazy, so come and get one. It's some fucks give it!
That little segment that we do every single week.
I love that P-Rock is trying to balance that hat on his ear.
Look at that patriot right there. Look at him go.
America!
America! He's been saving that hat.
Oh, he's so excited about their hat. That's what's so much. So, for those of you that don't know, B-Rock and I are in South Dakota. We are only 25 miles from Mount Rushmore.
RJ?
Never fails.
It never gets old.
We're 25 miles from Mount Rushmore. Donald Trump is set to speak there probably right now.
Oh, my God.
As we are doing this live. He is speaking before the fireworks, which, by the way, you guys, is the first fireworks. I don't know the exact year I live here, and I don't know this. Between 7 and 9 years, we have not been able to have fireworks because of the pine beetle infestation. It makes all of the pine trees in the Black Hills extremely flammable.
Oh, no.
So they cut the fireworks. But this year, because Donald Trump is speaking, they've decided to go forward with the fireworks. You saw some stuff on Facebook that was happening up there by Keystone where Mount Rushmore is.
Yeah, they've been blocking the roads, trying to not let people in. I think the National Guard is there. Obviously, this was kind of like a known thing that was going to happen, but it's pretty insane. I mean, especially with the fireworks, I don't know. Usually we have a drought, but right now it's been wet, so I'm not sure how I feel about it.
That's what he said.
Oh, shit.
He's like, fuck you.
Oh, man.
Yeah, it's super crazy. And the protests going on in the road are Native Americans indigenous to South Dakota that are basically saying you're on stolen land.
Right.
And so they're trying to stop everybody from going up there. And for those people that don't know, there was a nationwide lottery. You could apply on South Dakota website. I think it's the Game Fish and Parks website. And it was a lottery for 7,500 people that got drawn. In fact, my friends from LA got in on the lottery and they're sitting up there right now.
Oh, so they're only allowing a certain number of people in then.
7,500 people total, which is a lot.
That is a lot.
South Dakota's under fire right now because our governor announced, by the way, this was picked up by People magazine. This is fucking embarrassing if you ask me.
Oh no.
They are very vocally not practicing social distancing guidelines whatsoever in this. They are providing masks at the door for everybody. Yep. There is a medical tent that people I know actually help set up with wheelchairs and cots and oxygen tanks and all that stuff. Where we live is not that big, so I know several people involved in what's happening up at Mount Rushmore right now. They're like, no, we're not practicing social distancing. People are coming at their own risk. We encourage masks is basically what they were said. And they're putting hand washing stations.
You don't encourage. It needs to happen. Wear a mask. Like,
I mean, yeah, they need to make sure that they enforce that shit, because we've proven that if it's left up to the people to just kind of like ease back into normal life but still play it safe, it doesn't seem to be happening that way.
True.
So somebody in our comment thread is telling us that firework sales for this year is up 300%.
People want to blow shit up.
You know what? I really want to blow shit up. I've been stuck in my house all year. I got to blow shit up.
Fuck it. We're just going to do all this shit. It's crazy to me, though. Like, yes. And here in the U.S. today, it was like 90. It's like 90 degrees here today in South Dakota. I know people live in the tundra. Not accurate. Okay, not accurate. And it's super hot. And so nobody wants to wear a mask, especially today with what's going on.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I feel bad for people who have to wear masks at their job like 8 hours a day, you know, because now it's required. It's mandatory. And I mean, a lot of people will say it sucks. It's terrible. I mean, we had a guy install our security system in the house, and he wore a mask the whole time, and I was glad. But still, it's like, I mean, these people have to suffer wearing masks all day. You know, it's like we all need to do our part, you know?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
It's really not that. I mean, I don't know. I mean, the thing is that we're still getting like 50,000 plus cases a day. It's still happening.
Which is insane.
Yeah, so, it's insane. Yeah.
You guys, on that note, did you guys see that last weekend, this country singer, I follow country, I was born and raised on it. South Dakota.
I love country.
Chase Rice had a show in East Nashville last weekend.
I heard about this.
Yeah.
Yes. Yep. You guys, he is under fucking fire right now.
That was very irresponsible.
It wasn't just him, it was Chris Jansen. But here's the thing, is that Chase Rice was posting videos from the stage encouraging people to sing along.
It's like, you expected to say like, okay, now everybody turn to the person next to you and sing as loud as you can directly into their mouth.
Sing all your COVID or germs onto them, yeah.
Everybody put your fingers in everyone's mouths. Let's do it. Come on. Fuck everybody. Like, come on.
But here's the thing. If you're going to do a show, which a lot of the people in the industry, you know, that we know have been doing, you know, smaller shows here and there. However, from my understanding, there was still several thousand people at this show.
Ugh.
Yeah.
And then they post it and it goes viral. Kelsey Ballerini, another fellow country artist, and Maren Morris absolutely slammed Chase Rice.
Yeah. And that went viral just like the disease.
And like, those girls are super, super well respected and have bigger careers than Chase Rice does.
Oh yeah.
So I would feel like a fucking idiot if I were Chase Rice. Here's the thing, RJ, I'm sure you can relate. I'm ready to get back out on the road. I know you're ready to get out on the road. But if you're gonna do it, you're gonna wait till it's safe, or you're gonna do a way smaller show with social distancing or what have you.
Dude, live music is my life. Like, I want to get back on stage, and I also want to go to shows. I love going to shows. I want things to open up. I want people. I know people need work. People are hurting, you know, but now bars are packed and everything's, you know, back to normal, but it's making it worse. It's obviously making it worse.
Well, it's also like, I think our producer Dan said that he's been right about a lot of predictions with what's been going on.
He's been nailing it.
I mean, you're not going to get insurance to go on tour right now.
No.
Like,
that's right.
It's not going to happen at all. So
it shouldn't happen right now. It shouldn't happen.
What do you think about this, Dan? You want to come in?
Hey, it's Dan, everybody.
Dan, our producer.
All right, let's
on a happy one.
Let's get it, Dan. Let's get it.
Let's hear it. Yeah.
I honestly think that we are kaput for 2021. There's nothing's gonna happen. I don't think the MLB is gonna come back. NBA, I know everybody's in preparations, but I think everything's gonna get shut down the next couple weeks, including Vegas. I think it's all completely done.
Well, I did hear that the NBA is coming back, but obviously to no crowds or anything like that. But they're, which I'm happy about.
They're starting to get sick in practices, so I just think that.
Yeah.
Oh gosh,
it's the day. At the end of the day, it always comes down to insurance, and the building operators. I mean, Disney World's not going to be able to have insurance to protect anybody from getting sick. It's just, I just think that we're going to go into a nationwide shutdown. That is my prediction. I really believe that. I just think it's getting so out of control at this point that we're just going to have to go into an Italy-style lockdown.
Well, I heard that Chase, he released kind of an apology video or something like that.
Can we call it this? An apology video?
Show a clip of that for you.
What's up, y'all? Chase here, and I just want to address my show Saturday night. For those of you who don't know, I had a show in East Tennessee. Took a video of the concert. Everybody had a blast. But then once I posted the video, a lot of people seeing that online had a big problem with how the show looked, how the show went down. And I understand there's a lot of varying opinions, a lot of different opinions on COVID-19, how it works with live music, crowds, and what all that looks like. My biggest thing is y'all. Y'all are why I get to write songs. Y'all are getting to watch.
Pandering.
Why I get to do live shows and sing these songs to you guys, and you guys sing them back. You guys are everything to me. So your safety is a huge, huge priority. So moving forward, I have a show in Ashland, Kentucky on Friday, and it's a drive-in show.
And then he goes to promote all of his other stuff. It's like, come on, man.
I think he has a show right now in Kentucky as we're doing this.
Yeah.
Is this a drive-in show?
Yes.
Yeah, that was a drive-in show. So these drive-in shows that we're seeing, are obviously planned to be safe. And, there's a lot of safety precautions that are being taken. I mean, you have Live Nation behind a lot of them. People aren't allowed to leave either their car in some places. Other places, you're allowed to get out of your car and you can stay within your space. So those seem to be okay.
What was not shown in that video of Chase Rice was him promoting his show this weekend that is a drive-in show. And he encourages people to get out of their car.
Like Dan said, like you're in your zone, you're in your little spot, but I know it's a slippery slope because we know that you give people an inch and they take a mile.
Even
for roadies though. I mean, the people that have to set up the show, that's not safe.
You're exactly right. Think about the security. Think about the front of house team, the crew, like all these people, they're out there in the middle of all this, So you're right. That is very inconsiderate for them.
It's insane. It's fucking insane to me. And here's the thing too, is that he to me, the way he's presenting himself is absolutely screaming basically that he thinks this COVID is a whole big, stupid fucking joke. That's how it's coming to me. And like you said earlier, we're having 50,000 new cases a day. Yes, there's more testing, but that doesn't mean that more people aren't getting sick.
Like what he said, opinions. Everyone's got a different opinion. Like, oh, what we like. I'm sorry, but COVID-19, the disease, doesn't give a fuck about your opinion.
Right.
Did you hear about this other guy, this man that went out partying? He came down with COVID-19 and he released a video about, guys, don't go out. Don't go out. Don't go partying. And then sure enough, he got sick and he died.
How old was he too, by the way?
I think 41.
41?
He's okay. Young.
Yeah, that's not very old. I mean,
well, that's the other interesting thing. I think we're seeing that people took it for granted because there was this in the initial stages of COVID, we thought that it wasn't infecting young kids. It was only for, it was only danger to older people. Now we're seeing the biggest spike in cases are people under 35 right now. So that's a little alarming.
Yeah. We got to be smart about this. We got to keep our heads about this whole thing because it's still happening.
And something that Dan said too, is that, I'll attest to this. I've been along the ride for all of these predictions that he's giving, along for the ride, I should say. They have actually not been wrong. None of them have been wrong.
He's been right all the time.
I mean, there was a couple on the beach doing a photo shoot for their wedding, and the beach was like, get off my beach! Go home!
Yeah, look at that.
I mean, I do feel bad for them, but I mean...
So the wave came out and just like, boom, took them out, right?
Yeah, that was one of the funny highlights of the week. But I mean, obviously it was a very serious thing. They had to have the lifeguards in Laguna had to go out and get them. And they're actually having a problem here in Laguna Beach with lifeguards right now because a bunch of them came down with COVID-19.
Well, that sucks that you're putting more strain on the lifeguards too, you know, like by being irresponsible.
At least it was a little bit of light humor this week. I mean, they should have known better than to go down on the rocks by the water and get that. Well,
you live in Laguna. How many people live there in Laguna?
I think we're only 15,000.
15,000.
Small town, but at this time of the year, you know, it's jammed because it's tourist season. So, you know, it's a relatively small town. Everybody kind of knows each other, but you know, obviously it's 4th of July weekend. Even though the beaches were closed this weekend, it's packed everywhere. So summertime gets a little tight down here because everything's full, all the hotels and restaurants. Well,
some people are being responsible with this whole thing. Like one example is like the VMA awards are happening. Apparently they're happening, but they're going to do it in a way where like everyone's, you know, very separated and they've got ventilation systems installed to help prevent anybody from getting sick and all these things. Another thing is Vanilla Ice canceled his concert. And now you'd think like it's Vanilla Ice. I mean, no one's going to show up anyway, you know?
That was sold out, RJ.
Okay, I stand corrected. Sorry, sorry, guys. I didn't mean.
Don't talk shit about Vanilla Ice.
I'm sorry.
Don't talk shit about Rob Van Winkle. How dare you?
Oh.
Now I don't know if you guys saw. So he claimed that he didn't realize how bad COVID was in Texas, and that's why he's moving forward with the gig, which I just don't believe because.
Oh, I just didn't know.
What news show he had on the past 2 weeks? It was just talking about Texas and how bad things were there. So, you know, the defense to going for, I think, you know, the outrage was so much on him. It was so bad the past few days that's why he eventually canceled. But he claimed that he didn't know.
Well, you know, rightfully so.
I would claim that also.
So, we had a viewer ask, what is everybody's plans for the holiday?
You're looking at it.
Go ahead, Eva.
You guys, this is the first time in years I have not had actual plans. None.
Oh, yeah.
This is it, pretty much.
You know, I don't think – I really haven't done any, like, serious planning for 4th of July, I think, in years. Like, it's just been just kind of like a chill day to hang out and, you know, hang out with friends or whatever.
Yeah, I don't really have much plans. What me and my dad kind of have a tradition where we buy those tanks and we set them close to each other so that they can, like, battle each other.
Oh, the what?
Yeah, so those tanks, you know, you light like the ass end of them, and then they shoot at each other.
Oh, like the Roman candles?
Aren't they propane tanks or something?
Yeah, it's
so
just
you
like
shoot each other with fireworks.
It's been a tradition since I was like, you know, 10. So
well, that's the tradition that my cousins and I had was we would point bottle rockets at each other and shoot them in first lost.
Oh, God.
That sounds crazy.
You guys, we didn't have adult supervision. Our family was like...
Videos? Have you seen these videos online with all these Roman candle fights that are going on, like in New York City and everywhere?
No.
I'm talking like epic battles that are going on for hours with hundreds of people.
Yeah.
At least there's social distancing, right?
Just wear safety glasses. That's all I got to say.
I mean, COVID can't spread through fireworks that we know of. I mean, does it?
I'll give you my fourth of July plans are as you see it. I'm going to be sitting at home, social distancing with my family. It's the first time in almost a decade that we're actually not in New Jersey at our house, celebrating on the East Coast with our friends and our family there. So it's a little depressing that I'm stuck out here. I really want to be back east, but we're going to make the best of it, and we're going to spend some good, nice quality time. But with that, I'm going to sign off because I have to. Finish running the show for you guys, and you have a special guest coming up here, so let me
You have a, and before we get to that, we need to mention that a couple positive things are happening right now. A lot of artists have teamed up and released a song for the 320 Changes Direction benefit. It's in honor of Chester Bennington and for mental health, and it's really cool. I listened to it today, and it's just cool to see all these bands and artists coming together and doing something positive right now. There it is. It's gonna be okay. I promise it'll be okay. great. I mean, it's great that that we're keeping that in the forefront, because there's a lot of things going on right now. And yes, mental health is something very important. And it's something that we've touched on this season a lot. We talked about mental health. We talked about issues, with, you know, human right issues, like regarding race or gender, or, we've talked about pride and all these things. So it's great to see that those things are still in the forefront.
Yeah.
Absolutely. For sure.
Well, I think somebody's at the door, RJ.
Oh, I think I know who it is, too. It's time for our special guest to
stop, drop, and pop.
And who's popping in today?
It's
That's perfect right there.
Wow. You've lost weight. Oh, no, never mind.
I'm on a juice cleanse.
Oh yeah.
it's gin and juice cleanse.
Gin and juice cleanse. I've been on one of those.
So, one of our viewers, Tyler, was telling us that in America, Americans are at least you guys get the weekend to celebrate, because Canadian Independence Day is actually July 1st, correct?
Yes. We don't actually celebrate independence. The Canadians are still under the monarchy of the old queen there. But yeah, July 1st was the old Canada Day.
It's the monarchy of the French queen, right? It's the French queen.
Canada Day. That's nice.
Canada Day. Yeah. The French queen.
The French queen. Yes.
She's bilingual. She knows lots. She knows. Yeah. Who's got the drum roll? Is that you, RJ?
No. That's next door.
No, that's RJ. That's for sure.
Soundboard. And he moves and he does drum rolls 150 fucking times on the show. And somebody take that goddamn thing away from him.
Hey, Tyler, ask B Rock and Eva where they live.
Guys live?
South Dakota.
Rapid City.
Never gets old. Never gets
Trump,
old.
Trump is actually here tonight, right now.
At like, Mount Rushmore. It's Canada. Miles from our house.
Yeah, 15 minutes away.
It's wild.
What's there to do in South Dakota? Herd cows.
Well, you can go cow tipping. You can go rollerblading. You can go tubing, boating.
Tubing, to be honest, like it all sounds like things that Canadians like to do as well. The tubing is very, very popular in the summer. You just grab like a case of beer, you float something down a river. Is that what you're talking about? Floating down
a
river.
Yeah, yeah. And then they're kind of like your immediate downstairs neighbors too. So,
Jesus.
Yes, yes, they are pretty close.
They're close.
We have some super passionate fans here, Tyler, because we are just getting our ass ripped in the beginning of the show. They're like, "Where's Tyler? I'm never watching this shit again. We're here for Tyler."
Where's Tyler?
That was just me.
Right here.
That was your mom, right?
That was my mom. My mom doesn't watch TV, really. All she watches is like Downton Abbey. Me and my mom actually went to a Downton Abbey. She came visit me in L.A. once, and I'm like, "What do you want to do?" She's like, "I don't know. What's going on in town?" I'm like, "Mom, there's a Downton Abbey premiere at some theater." And she's like, "Let's go."
Nice.
So we were the only people there that weren't dressed up like Downton Abbey characters. And it was a highlight. It was a highlight of my summer.
I could see you being in Peaky Blinders.
Peaky Blinders can be good. I just need a hat that has razor blades on it.
Yes, so I could see you being – you could make a cameo on that show.
I'm down. I've got some Irish blood in me.
So,
I could do
that. What's going on? Are you guys? Did you change your name to just Theory?
It's Theory .. Now I've changed it.
Oh,
I've changed it myself.
Okay. What's the reason?
Someone asked that today. It's whatever you want it to be. Honestly, I think it stemmed from the fact that a lot of new fans had a hard time remembering the name. I would be in the back of an Uber or getting my haircut in some city on tour, and someone would be like, "So what do you do? What's your social security number? What's your PIN number?" And I'd be like, "Well, I play in a band." "What's your band called?" "Theory of a Deadman." And then, but when I'm leaving, they're like, "Oh, I'm going to check out your band, man. Fiery, the Theory, Theory of the Madman.
Theory of the Madman.
I got it. Diary of a Madman." I'm like, "That's it."
Oh, no.
Yeah, that's it.
Well, I mean, I know because we've toured with you guys a bunch of times, and God, God, touring with you guys is fun. I love touring with you guys. But I feel like everybody refers to you as just Theory anyway. You know, they're like, oh, who are you touring with? Oh, we're touring with Theory. And everybody knows what you're talking about.
Yeah, when we did it. It was just, I think, for new fans, they were like, what's this band called? Theory. And we have, you know, our old fans still call us Theory of a Deadman. I'd still say Theory of a Deadman. Whose idea was it? You know, I think it was Dave's idea. Let's blame it on Dave, the guitar player.
Good. He deserves it, I'm sure.
So there you go.
Fuck that guy.
That's it.
Dave, I hope you're watching.
Yeah, fuck you, Dave.
Yeah, where is Dave? Oh, can you swear on this?
It's always Dave.
There's Dave.
Dude, Dave, there was one time when I was like, when I was filming you guys, and he was like just flicking pics at me, like just nonstop.
He's deadly.
Damn it, Dave.
Dave is deadly with accuracy. He does stuff for like tricks where he can bounce the pick in the middle of a show, bounce it and catch it again and keep playing.
He's good at that.
Wow. He can just like, he can like see some of the audience. And so, you know, I remember some girl came up to us after a show or something, was like, I was singing, all of a sudden this pick like went in my mouth. I was like, oh.
That's sanitary.
Yeah, whose pick was it? It was like, it was this one. It's always Dave's. Goes down someone's shirt. Always Dave.
Well, he has turned my guitar player into a pick throwing addict because he's the exact same way, and he's very deadly accurate with that shit.
Oh yeah.
What about you? Do you do any of that?
Yeah. I've got more distance. Mine's more long game. I can get it. I'm all about length.
Sorry,
so I'm
Eva.
All about length.
You don't gotta apologize to me. My picks
seem to curve a little bit to the right.
Oh, that happened. Well, do you think that Dave is more about the motion? He's more about he's not about the size of the distance. It's more about what you do with it.
It's not the size of the pick. It's the length of how you throw it.
Ah.
Dave's pick throwing is cute.
Ah. What about? Well, what
it's
about
just right?
What about Dean? Does Dean throw his fingers out in the crowd?
Dean's actually got like 1 mil or 2 mils, so they could kill. I think they could probably cut it like a jugular.
Oh, those are like throwing stars. Too.
But I think he's more like finger guy. And then Joe, depending on how he feels, you know, drummers, you know,
he throws
out the sticks usually at the end of the show, right? You guys are crazy.
Oh yeah, no, that shit's we actually did a show where I nailed somebody right in the eyebrow with a drumstick, and I felt really bad. And luckily, he didn't sue us or anything, but he was just very cool about it. We gave him like a CD and a T-shirt and all this. Like, hey, please don't sue us. We love you. You know, it's a free show. It's some free T-shirts and stuff. And he was like so proud of it. He's like, dude, I'm a music teacher. I'm gonna go and tell all my students about this. This is so cool. And it looked bad. It was like bubbling.
It's just an A. It's just an A. Hey, what's a CD?
Yeah, exactly.
I was wondering the same thing. What is that?
Oh man, isn't that scary? I think our first record came out on cassette. We've been around a while.
Cassette to it?
No, there's no cassettes when we came out, but
you're showing your age there, Tyler.
I was gonna say I'm not super young, but I only owned a few cassettes before CDs came out.
Yeah, I'm old. I had cassettes, records. I remember, I think I purchased the Miami Vice soundtrack for my sister for her birthday. That was probably what, I don't know what year that was. I remember I bought a friend of mine at his, I think his 10th birthday. I might be off on the date, but I bought him License to Ill on record.
Oh, nice.
Nice! Yeah. Dude, that shit is like collectors.
Do you remember those CD players, like the portable ones that had like an anti-skip thing? So when he would run,
I was at the Discman. Was the Discman that had the anti-skip? Yeah. I think it was a Sony Discman.
Yeah. Nobody ran with those. The anti-skip were when you had to put it in your car with the cassette adapter.
Right.
God, then those were expensive back then. I think I just saw one at Goodwill for like $1.
Goodwill.
Yeah.
What are you doing in the Goodwill?
Nothing.
Nothing for his jackets.
Just doing some Goodwill. That's
look, hard times, man. Hard times.
They have terrible shoes in the Goodwill. I'll have to say that. They got everything else is amazing. Their shoe selection is tough. It's
well,
tough.
I know you, Tyler, have really nice shoes. You tour with like really fine shoes.
I like shoes. I do find that they have better shoes overseas. Like the UK has the most fantastic shoes.
Like London.
Fabulous. London, England.
London,
UK.
Barcelona. Barcelona.
Three different cities.
All those countries. The entire Europe. Well, basically just that. But
all of Europe.
So, Tyler, you guys just did you guys have World Keeps Spinning, which is a great song, and you guys just did that live in basically your studio and everyone else's.
Right.
Yeah, and then you also have like a live, you produce like a live DVD coming out, right? Or a live performance.
There it is. Yeah.
Stop, drop, shut. Oh, shit. Sorry, I hit the wrong button. My first day.
Talk about that a little bit. If you can.
I played there. That's a great venue.
Yeah, it's in Montreal. It's awesome. Yeah. It's awesome. Yeah. It was just the label was like, we want to come out and film. As usual, it was like last minute. And we're like, yeah, sure. It was like at the end of a Canadian tour. And the night before, we were in Toronto. And we had met with our whole label, came out. I think there was probably about 30 people and came backstage before the show. And I'm kind of like RJ, get a little goofy, get a little energetic around people.
No. That's why we never get along, right?
Right. And so like there, we took this big photo and there was like some huge bowl or something made out of metal. And I don't know, it was a really weird backstage. And then there was these huge metal things with couches in them. And I decided to start doing pull-ups on one of them. Yeah, I'm so strong. And I didn't realize there were these sheet metal birds sticking down. And I did a pull up and I literally just, this piece of metal grinded and went all across my face.
Oh, no.
It was about half an hour before the show. And like, immediately there was like a blood. And Dave thought I cut my hand. There was all this blood. I'm like, oh. So we had to. Yeah, you can. It's hard to see now, but there's like a. Where is it?
It wasn't rusty, was it?
Oh, yeah, it was rusty. I had to get a tetanus shot.
Oh, yeah.
Of course it's rusty.
Update on your tetanus boosters?
Yeah, I had to get a booster. Yeah, and it was just like, it was a huge gash, like needed stitches. And it was just bleeding everywhere. And they brought someone backstage and like, well, you know, we can, you can go to the hospital or you can just, I don't know, put a Band-Aid on it. I'm like, do you have any like butterfly stitches? They're like, no. And then I'm like, what do you guys do? Are the paramedics, you know, go to shows? I'm like, what do you guys usually do here? And they said they usually deal with people that green out. Have you ever heard green out? It's
green
like blackout.
Out?
Green out is the new thing now that kids do. It's like blackout, but it's from
but
too
it's
much
green.
Marijuana. It's too much, I guess. Green out.
So what, you fall asleep?
No, I don't know. I guess, you know, people do green edible. Out. They smoke it. They just, I don't know. They wear it.
I guess that's a new thing now.
Yeah, I guess they just says we get a lot of green outs. I'm like, what?
Green outs?
So
wow.
So I guess kids just throwing up. Because
you got that legal weed up there.
Yeah, it's pretty it's crazy in Canada, man. But
you're not there now.
No, I'm not there now.
You're in California.
I'm in California.
How's the lockdown been for you out there?
It's been great. Don't you live in, where are you, Sherman Oaks?
No.
Oh, well, I have a place in Woodland Hills now, but I also have a
RJ,
place in Nashville.
RJ, what's your home address?
Sure. It's 6.
Are you in like Burbank or North Hollywood? Or
yeah, what? Burbank.
Hello, okay. Burbank. How's Jay Leno? Is he your neighbor?
Jay Leno is my. I have seen Jay Leno actually drive around in his crazy cars. It's quite often, actually. He's just be at a red light, and there's him at some steam locomotive thing or something. But anyways, I got a cut on my head. I don't know where it was, but and so the next night we had to film this thing, and it was all like, you know, I had like this gooey gel Vaseline or something all on it, and we went on stage, and I was just like, you can see it in the live thing. It's just this gooey, disgusting, wide open thing. Because I either was going to wear a huge like. One of those huge square Band-Aids that actually went over my eyebrow. And I'm like, this looks so fucking stupid. So I just ripped it off and it was gross.
Well, that's why you
but
keep
you can
your
check that out.
You keep your Brett Michaels bandana handy just for that reason.
Yes. And yeah, depending on how low The cut is I can bring it down all the way like suicidal tendencies slow.
Exactly.
Yeah. The one was a touch.
So if our viewers want to see the gooey grossness on Tyler's eyebrow, I mean, check out it's the 30-minute live edit of the show available on their YouTube page, on Theory's YouTube page.
Very cool.
Yes. You can check it out. Yeah, the label picked the songs. They sent to us. So what do you think about these five songs? And it's always the label's fault, right? So we're like, yeah, it's great. Sure. But, you know, I think we probably did 16 songs and so I'm sure that there could be more to count. Who knows?
So you just blame it on the label. If it's terrible, just blame it on the label.
So, yeah, well, if anything sucks, it's their fault. If it's amazing, it's my idea.
It's artist genius, right? That's how that goes. What's this I hear about you almost getting arrested with B-Rock?
Oh, yeah.
Where was that?
At a haunted house?
Well, Tyler, so I was on, what was that tour? Shit. It was with Alter Bridge, Blackstone Cherry.
Oh, it was at,
Madness.
I forgot. Yes, of course, yeah. So
Carnival Madness.
I don't know if you remember, but we were in Big Flats. And there was a haunted house, and we went back there.
Yes!
And then the cops came, and they were going to arrest them. Yeah, exactly.
The guy came in, he was like, get the fuck out of here!
Yeah, I remember that. I was frightened, man. I mean, I was totally frightened. And then the next day, you were like, hey, can you teach me some camera stuff? I'm like, it was just kind of a funny story.
I do remember we snuck because it was like they had it set. It was all shut down because I guess it was probably right around Halloween or something. So we just snuck into it. And of course, as soon as we started running around it, all these alarms went off. And I remember some guy, for some reason, I thought he had a gun, but I think it just sounds cooler, like me holding a shotgun. Get the fuck!
which is always tricky at a haunted house because there's all that kind of scary things popping out at you all the time. And it's like, you don't really know, like, oh shit, is this real?
Yeah, no, it was all real. There was murderers.
Oh, good.
Are you like a huge Halloween fan, like haunted house kind of?
Yeah,
kinda?
I love
me
it.
Too.
Yeah,
Tyler, if you ever come to Nashville, I need to take you to Nashville Nightmare. It's a haunted house thing, like adventure, and it's open all year round.
Hello.
Oh my God.
Dude, they do a Valentine's Day theme. They do an Arbor Day theme. They do a Mother's Day theme. It's amazing.
How do you not know about this? Brock and I are coming to Nashville. B-Rock and I are headed there.
No!
You're not invited.
You're not going to take us there?
Yeah.
You got to come.
Yeah.
There it is.
Nashville, that's our
producer. I went to a Christmas theme, which okay. So like, let's be honest. They don't really go all that out. They basically for the Christmas theme, they throw some Christmas lights over the scary monsters. For Valentine's Day, they add little hearts. You know, but still, it's actually pretty good.
Me, Dean. Was the bass player, and it's usually like one or two of the crew guys. We are obsessed with those haunted house things. So anytime we're on tour around Halloween, it's just like every city, me and Dean are like, okay, where are we going tonight? And we usually find a couple of crew guys to Uber somewhere, and it's we like rate it. We're like, that one was pretty good. I think that's like 7 out of 10.
Wait, actually, I remember you and I, Tyler, went to a haunted house in Hamburg, Germany once when we did our very first Europe tour ever was with you guys back in 2010, yeah. And but it was really shitty. It was like basically like a carnival fun.
It was. Dude, that carnival is there every year. We went back.
Yeah.
We went back on our last record and had a day off there. It was still there. We went on the bumper cars and shit, which were totally illegal. I think they went 30 miles an hour. But I'm like, this is where we went. I remember me and you hung out and went through that terrible like walkthrough. Haunted house thing. It was on the back of like a rig or something.
By whose standards?
What's that?
I said illegal by whose standards for the bumper cars?
Well, I mean, in Germany, baby, anything goes. It's just like
it's Autobahn.
Yeah, it was bumper cars on the Autobahn. Like we all,
Porsche.
I think there was 7 or 8 of us, and
that sounds terrible.
I remember getting hit so hard, my hat flew off, and I like had whiplash. It was so much fun, though. I mean.
You're beating yourself up on tour, Tyler.
Tyler, what do you think? Would you be maybe the Tiger King this year for Halloween?
I don't know. There's so many crazy things that could happen. I used to be the Tiger King, dude. Our first record. I mean, you have a photo from our first album.
Can we get a
I was the Tiger King for real.
A photo of Tyler as the Tiger King.
Can you grow a mullet? A mullet for us? Come on.
I actually had a mullet. I cut this like a week ago. I had a full mullet.
I had
quarantine hair. I let it grow, and it was awesome. But
I totally forgot to ask that. Like, how have you been getting haircuts?
Well, I just ordered a razor online on Amazon. That's it. That's not it.
looking good, Tyler.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. I would be a good Tiger King. You know what's crazy is that I watched that doc, right? The series.
Yeah.
And then I told my sister, I'm like, Trish, you gotta watch this this Tiger King documentary. And then she watched it and she called me and she's like, I've been to that, you know, the one episode where there's that crazy like mafia dude that has people buried in his killed people and stuff.
Oh yeah.
So it's like like a Scarface off of. There I am.
Oh yeah, there's Tyler, there it is. Looking good.
My sister's been to that place. She's like, I've been there. And I'm like, oh my God, did you help bury bodies? I'm trying to find a photo of myself from the first album.
I can't find
I'm sure Dan's probably got one already.
Dan's on it. Our producer is like, he's searching already. He probably is.
He's a little obsessed with you.
Look at this.
Yeah, he's
Yeah,
look at that mustache, man.
Oh yeah.
Wow.
Look at Dave Brenner. Look at the choker on me too.
Look at Dave.
That's actually my screensaver. I pretended to look for the photo.
Love this guy.
Hey, by the way, no joke, that was the label's fault. They wanted me to have a handlebar mustache for real.
Again, blaming the label. Yeah.
There it is.
That's the only way to go. I would have figured you probably sang a System of a Down at this point.
You look like a Mexican.
Yeah, no kidding.
There it is.
So, how was it transitioning from the Cartel to music, Tyler?
I don't know, but man, I was hot. That mustache. You know what? You know when I shaved that?
Yeah.
I shaved that when a lady came up to me. I say lady because she was an adult. Came up to me after a show and said, I want to go for a mustache ride, and that was it. I shaved it immediately afterwards.
I just fucking said that.
Did you say that? I didn't hear you.
Oh, yeah.
So I had to play it. It's my favorite song ever.
Oh,
that's my theme song, by the way.
Sorry.
We wrote for when we do Eva After Hours.
The hottest show on television.
Very nice.
Keep going.
We only do that a couple times a season, but it's a sex and relationship advice from somebody completely unqualified.
We're all unqualified to be doing this.
She helps me a lot since I'm single. A lot.
Oh nice. What happens right now if you're on Tinder or Grindr? Are they just screwed? Are people going on there?
I gotta be honest.
Have you heard about like the tips that like the health experts have been telling people about having sex? They say you should definitely wear a mask while you're having sex, and if you don't want to get too close, and you should probably either masturbate with each other, which is a safe way to do it, 6 feet apart, or you should have a wall barrier with something to access the parts.
Also, don't
basic worry.
That's what they say. Literally, don't eat ass.
And don't eat ass.
That's
well,
amazing.
You should never eat ass.
I agree with you, RJ. I think that we should always, you know, at this time, masturbate 6 feet away from each other at all points.
That social distance circle here. What the fuck is happening right now?
I know it's you can't even play. You can't. Okay, I'm
don't eat ass, Jesus.
Do not eat ass, ladies and gentlemen. This is a serious pandemic.
Who invited me on this show? Sorry.
Oh, geez.
Too back hilarious. To so, anyway,
I'm glad you're on board, Tyler.
Well, we've all worked with him before, so we knew what we were getting into. We knew what to expect. We knew what he would tolerate. We'll put it that way.
How's your experience has been on Grindr, Tyler?
I haven't been on Grindr. I was speaking for anybody that may be watching that has experienced it. We did have a... We did.
Oh, shit.
There's a great kind of story that we tried to play a trick on a crew guy years ago where he was obsessed with Tinder and he wouldn't hook up with any women. So I'm like, I'm getting a Tinder account. So I started a Tinder account with a fake girl. Her name was Tyra O'Connell, which is pretty close, right? So I found he was from, I think, from Boston. So I had all this, like, this chick, she went to Boston College and all this. That.
Oh, yeah.
And so then I find out, like, on Tinder, you have to have, like, a Facebook or something to sign up. So I had to start a fake Facebook page, Tyra O'Connell. Really? I had to put in a fake photo. I went all the way. I had to put in a fake photo, like, I'm at the library, stuff like that. And so then, like, I guess on Tinder, you can see who's around you, like, in the same vicinity.
Oh yeah. So did you get any fans following you on Tinder?
No. I would then like hit him up on Tinder saying, "Hey, it's Tyra. Let's hook up tonight."
Tyra.
And he's like, "Hi." Yeah, and he's like, "Nice try, buddy." I guess he went, you know, you can go and look at their profile. And it's like zero friends. Facebook created 3 days ago. I'm like, the good news is I've kept the Tyra O'Connell Facebook for years and I get friends all the time trying to like, you have a new friend request from like my mom trying to befriend Tyra O'Connell. I'm like, Mom, that's not
Tyra
me.
O'Connell.
There you go.
That's hilarious.
Go befriend Tyra O'Connell. Go befriend Tyler O'Connell and we'll I don't know. I have no idea what happens on Facebook. I don't have one.
From what I understand.
Oh my God. Get on Hinge, dude.
I don't know how to work Tinder. I've never had it. However,
Hinge is better.
It's
Hinger.
It's
Hinger. Hinderinder.
What about Hinder?
Oh, yeah.
Hinder would be good. You get to date someone from Hinder.
Yeah, they need their own dating app.
Do a shot.
So you could have a Hinder app. It's like a Jaeger shots. And
there we go.
Blower? Is he on Hinder? What's happening?
Blower has to be on Hinder. He's dating on Hinder for sure. Blower.
He's dating on Hinder. If you're dating on Hinder, please leave a comment.
But from what I understand, with Tinder, it only pulls up people near you, around you. How does
it
work?
Got like location in it.
Yeah, you have like a radius. Being the single guy,
you
I know how it works.
What the radius is?
Yeah, you can do like 50 to I think 100 mile radius. But what you have to worry about is a lot of them are fake.
Catfishing.
Like, hey,
like Tyler.
like visit my Instagram.
Tyria O'Connell.
I set mine to 5 to 10 feet. So I get a lot of hits. I get a lot of swipe rights. Swipe right? Is that good?
Yeah, right is good,
swipe
right?
Swipe right?
Sure, yeah. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that.
So I went with a girlfriend one time to Denver.
Is it a 5 foot radius? You're getting some hits.
I do a 5'10".
You know what you're gonna find on Tinder when you have a 5 foot radius? Your hand's going to come up on Tinder.
Like, hey, remember me?
Yeah.
And then your left hand's going to be like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
What the fuck? Who's that?
Christ, you guys.
Sorry, Eva. Love you. We have a woman on the show as well.
I just got Venmo'd. I just got Venmo'd $1,000 from Tinder for the, giving him a shout out.
Oh, good job. So you're sponsored by Tinder.
I'm now sponsored by from Tinder.
Oh, good.
18-year-old girl. Yeah, that's yeah. Isn't there a movie called Catfish or something? It's really creepy.
Oh yeah, I heard about that. I haven't seen it yet.
Good. I've seen it. Yeah, I've seen it.
I've seen a show on MTV called Catfish that was started by that guy. The host was actually catfished originally, which is how the show got started.
I've seen the MTV one with it's like, you know, we should have, yeah, it's like, well, I don't know, I'm thinking of Bobcat Goldthwait. Sorry. Oh.
I love me some Bobcat.
So I don't think any of our viewers are surprised with it being the season finale and watching our entire season and having Tyler as our guest right now. We are off the fucking rails.
Tyler!
We're having fun. Tyler from the band Theory of a Madman.
The Theory of a Dead Guy.
Dead? What? What is well, it? You're theory? From, what?
You're from Canada, so you say things like, hey there, guy, and, you know, like, hey, bud. Guy.
Bud is a big one.
Hey, bud. Oh, I say bud all the time. B-Rock will tell you. I'm like, hey, bud.
Bud's making
something. Yeah. What?
There's not a lot of A though. Where I grew up, there's not a lot of A. I think that's East Coast, more of the A. What's going on, eh?
See, in South Dakota, if we like run into each other, like in the aisle, we always say, "Oh,
oh, 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 oh." The most South Dakota thing you can ever say is, "Oh, just gonna sneak past you and grab the ranch."
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, ranch.
Oh, South Dakota.
Oh, ranch. Puppy chow, caramel.
Yeah, it's like that show. It's like that movie Fargo.
No, it fucking is not, RJ.
It's not ever like that.
It's exactly. I mean, there's people grinding up legs in like those wood chippers. That happens in Fargo.
Yeah.
Yes, which
that's
is
no also
happens at the Tiger Ranch.
That's true. That is true. Is it still open or what?
Do you think that she did it?
Did she bury her husband?
You think that she killed her husband? Huh?
Yeah, he's. It's interesting that he is not. Shown up, how in 2020 can no one find someone? It's interesting.
Yeah,
that's true.
But you know, guys, hey, come on, innocent till proven guilty, right?
that's right. You heard it from Tyler himself.
But I think I have my costume for Halloween is going to be her husband. I think that's a good one.
In a meat grinder, or you're just going to go to the party?
I think Dave should dress up like Carol Baskin, and you should dress up like her husband.
Yeah, I think it's fantastic.
With like worms and like tiger spit all over you.
Good. Yeah, I don't know. He's probably gone. He probably didn't pack up and move to Tahiti. I don't think that's. I think they would have figured that one out.
It was Costa Rica. Did you really watch the documentary? Come on.
I never saw it. What is it? No, I saw it. Yeah, Costa Rica.
Everybody fucking saw it.
Everyone saw it. It was mandatory.
Yeah.
Mandatory viewing.
She covered him in sardine oil.
Supposedly.
I love
allegedly.
It. Allegedly. Fantastic. Why is there so many unsolved murders that we get us so excited? It's awesome.
Oh, my God.
Isn't it amazing unless it happens to you?
Have you guys seen that Netflix just came out with a brand new reboot of Unsolved Mysteries that came out on the 1st?
Ah.
It's 6 episodes. I'm 2 episodes in. It is so fucking good. So
wait,
good.
Who was the original host for that?
Robert Stack.
A long time ago.
That guy was like, that guy had the nice smoky voice. That he was the
Captain Moncoat, always.
Yes. Yeah. In South Dakota, there's not much to do other than bury it.
There's still plenty of land to bury bodies.
Hey, Brock.
Plenty of land. Yeah.
Hey, Brock, something you may not know about Robert Stack is he actually passed away on our birthday 1 year. B-Rock and I share a birthday.
Oh.
Yeah, which one? Which birthday?
The May 14th birthday.
May 14th.
Oh, my
yeah.
God, May 14th.
We're both... We're both 22.
Congratulations. There he is.
We're not 22, but that's, not judging that.
Speaking of voiceover work, Tyler, I kind of like to think of you as the Canadian Sam Elliot. You've got such a chocolatey, nutrageous-y, leathery, velvety voice. Have you ever done any voiceover work or ever done any commercials like Stouffer's, Nothing Comes Closer to Home or anything like that?
Well, if it would be probably start with Rice-A-Roni would be my number one go-to.
Rice-A-Roni.
I did a Budweiser thing once years ago. I don't know what it was for, but it was some voiceover and I think it was like Anheuser-Busch. St. Louis, Missouri.
Oh,
it was
there
like
you go.
I just literally said something like that. Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
No kidding. Are you still getting paid for that?
I got a check for $500,000 actually on Venmo just right now from Budweiser.
Thank you, Budweiser. Now that's America. Hire a Canadian to do it right.
I think it was quite a bit of money actually for whatever it was for.
Very cool.
I took a voiceover lesson, and by the way, it's really, really hard. It is not
really?
As easy. It's so hard. It's really, really hard.
What's involved with it?
I think it's just it's just like anything else. It's just training. The way they do it's the vernacular. I don't know. I just use that word because it makes me sound smart. But it's very difficult. It's a lot of enunciation. It's kind of like singing. It's just like a lot of, I don't know. But the guy that I took a lesson with, he. he did a lot of radio stuff, a lot of voiceovers for commercials, and he's just like one of those guys. Hey. He had one of those voices. But he was all like fake. He went into it. It was just like he had a regular voice, and he's like, "Kid, it was more like this." Next, on Unsolved Mysteries. He had kind of one of these Casey voices.
You see, I have one of those voices, but I prefer to call it a gift from God.
Yes.
I have a radio voice when I do radio. Oh, I have like my normal voice, and then I have the Black Hills Best Rock 95.1 Case Guy. You know, like you have your radio voice, yeah. Normal voice.
We hear it on the show.
That's good. That's good. I like that.
Also, I feel like Tyler would be a super great replacement for Mayhem in those like insurance commercials.
Ooh, not bad.
Mayhem.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
I think so. Yeah, I think he'd do well.
Company is.
You could be the next Trivago guy.
Trivago could be good.
Trivago.
I like those commercials.
Yeah. So Tyler, you've been doing a bunch of you kind of whistle in quite a few songs lately, correct?
Yes.
You're very good at it.
Very good.
If you're comfortable, do you think you could do one from RX or like World Keeps Spinning?
Yeah. You know what's funny is that fans see us play live and they all think I'm lip syncing. They don't, they all like, that's not really you whistling up there, is it? Like, yes,
it is. Yeah,
that would be really embarrassing if like I was whistling and then I dropped the mic and then it kept going. That would really be outside.
But you would have to do it just to prove you're really doing it.
So which one would you like to do?
I'll do RX.
Okay,
I can do it now. It's smiling.
Awesome.
Yeah, that's it. Right? That's
hey,
it.
There we go.
Yeah, cool. Thank you.
Woo! Man, that is some expert whistling.
I actually cannot whistle. That's something I cannot do.
Let's hear it.
I literally
can't. Try it. Give it a shot. Come on.
Like.
Oh, no.
My dad growing up could do, you know, those guys that can do like the super loud whistle with, or the like the. Some guys have to put their fingers in their mouth, but my dad would do it. He would just go, and it'd be like the loudest thing I've ever heard.
I don't know how people do that.
It's like, whoosh, 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 whoosh.
Yeah, so.
My 10-year-old can whistle. I cannot whistle. She's like, "Hey, mom, whistle," and I'm like, "Yeah, piss off. I can't. You know, I can't."
It's all training. It's like voiceover. You just got to train 8 hours a day.
That's right.
That sounds terrible.
This is the whistling military.
That's right.
I'll just carry a whistle around my neck if I ever need to do like the lunch call on the farm.
There you go.
Well, you could say you can whistle. You just maybe it's only certain animals can hear it. It's so high, maybe.
Yeah.
And maybe that can be your excuse.
You have a natural dog whistle.
Only dogs can hear me.
That's right.
I'll do it right now. Oh, my dog's freaking out.
Wait.
There you go.
This is just wonderful. I hope everyone's really enjoying this part of the show.
Do you have people that are typing in right now? Is it kind of like
No, we have people leaving. We have people like closing out, like, oh my god, this is terrible.
No, they're
Nancy says, "Oh my god, love the whistle more." I think she's talking to you, Tyler, since my whistle didn't make any sound.
Yeah.
I want to know how you get the vibrato while you're whistling, because it's like a... Like, I can't...
Yeah, you're pretty good.
Well, now it's just like the Twilight Zone.
Yeah, I don't know. It's a gift from God, as R2 would say.
It's a gift from God.
What's your gift from God? It's definitely whistling vibrato.
Whistling vibrato.
And I can do I can whistle any note. That's a D sharp.
What's your whistling range? Like, what's your highest and lowest? Like how many octaves do you have in your whistle range?
I mean, it's not much. It's not much. Like, probably an octave. I don't know.
Emily's wondering why your whistle sounds like Snow White and Cinderella.
Yeah, it's well, I speak to the animals.
Yeah.
The animals love it.
We're standing in the front yard right now.
So many woodland creatures just flock to Tyler, you know? Like in a Disney
movie.
There's
nights where it's like super dry on stage, especially when we're doing RX. When we do RX, everyone starts smoking. And so like about halfway through the song, I'm like, it gets so dry from all the smoke and dope.
Oh, yeah.
So by the end of the set, sometimes I'm so high by the end of the set.
Oh yeah.
And then I go back to do the whistle and I can't, I got nothing. That's so dry. I'm like, I got nothing.
Until eventually you just green out.
Then I just green out.
Green out.
You learn something new every day, kids.
Look so at Tyler, that. When you write songs, do you ever like actually come up with them with just a simple whistle and then write them afterwards?
I don't even know where the whistle came from. Like, honestly, that was not definitely not the first thing that came up, especially with RX. But I don't know.
Maybe you can kind of explain. I'm just curious the evolution of the song RX, because I'll be just real quick. I got to be honest. I love the way that you guys have evolved with your sound over your career. Like, if you listen from your first record up until your latest record, like, you guys have come in this amazing journey to where you guys are now. What was kind of the inspiration to kind of like shaking things up and trying new sounds?
I don't think it was just maybe complacency. Maybe you write so many songs, you have, you know, that was our, what was that? Oh, it was our sixth record. So, you know, we did five records and, I don't know if I had any more riffs. I think there was no more riffs to write. And so I was just honestly just trying to do something different. But RX came out of nowhere. It came from the ether. I think I was trying some stupid thing where I'm like, I'm going to write a song a day and see how long I can go. Seriously. And I got to like day three and I literally sat down. I was like, I am so freaking bored. And that was the song. I think I was bored.
Wow.
Yeah, and I don't know, the chorus came first, and then I just filled in the blanks, I think, kind of later on.
It's great when those songs just kind of come together so quickly, just spill out in like 5 minutes, and those are like sometimes the best songs, right?
They usually are. Usually the ones you have to sit there and grind, and you're like, I don't know, what rhymes with heaven above? I don't know, rhymezone.com, and you're like... So I don't now. Like nowadays, I have no problem pushing delete on any idea. Just do it. Just push delete. Just don't even bother finishing it, because there's a reason. If it takes you too long to write a song, just move on. It's just not working.
I think that's probably a good rule of thumb for a lot of songwriters. Is that you're right. If you get to the point where you're just it's not working, and sometimes it does. Like sometimes, like for a couple songs that I've written, like I'll have like one section written. Or I'll have like this one song I wrote. I had like the beginning of a chorus, and it was stuck in my head, and I was really stoked about it, but I couldn't figure out how to finish it, like where to go from there. And then like months later, just came to me like, oh, I should go this way. So sometimes that happens.
That's true. That's amazing. That I'm so freaking lazy. I just like I lose interest in shit. So I usually spend about an hour. An hour probably on a song, and that's it. That's all I got. If I can't figure it out in an hour, I just quit.
Probably a good rule of thumb, because you're right. Like the ones that just kind of pour out of you and come together so quickly are sometimes your best shit, you know? I love the way that you guys were bold enough to experiment with new sounds and to keep it fresh for your fans and also for new fans.
Well, I mean, I've reminded the guys too before, in the band, I go, you know, when we started as a band, there were no fans, there was no label, there were no people, there was no radio, there was no people kind of directing us, no A&R. So where did this passion, where did these ideas come from?
Right.
This came from this natural place of...
National.
This came from this national...
From this great nation.
Yeah, with liberty.
That's for all, right?
I don't know, like...
That's patriotism.
Oh my God! On that note, you
anyway.
Kids,
there you go. Yeah,
insane. Tyler, are you good to stick around for a little game with us?
Let's do it.
All right, let's do it.
All right, so then it's time for a little bit of
stop, drop, shenanigans. Stop, drop, shenanigans. You'll never get me gold.
That's right. You'll never get me gold.
Look at Tyler's face.
Like, what the fuck was that?
That's so good.
Your reaction is genuine because I literally slapped that together in like 5 minutes and it just kind of stuck.
RJ,
again, those are the songs that come naturally.
Do you think in season 2 I'll fucking remember to introduce that segment ever?
I got your back, girl.
Need merch. Where's the merch?
We're working on it.
Oh, look. Tyler's trying to get free merch. What the fuck?
Tyler, you want this one? You know what this is, right?
That's great.
You want this one?
That's a, yeah, I know what that is. That's an Ewok, I think.
Wait, I got mine. Hang on.
Young Yoda.
Hey, Dirty Sexy Ryan.
Dirty Sexy Ryan. Oh, nice. I like it. Promo.
That's a metal, a metal burlesque dance group that I own. Shameless plugging.
Awesome. Let's play this.
I plug my team as well.
Yeah!
LSU, baby.
Oh, LSU. Oh, no. Oh, no.
So we like to play a little game with all of our guests. We switch it up every week. This week we decided to go with Never Ever Have I Ever.
Oh, right.
For those of you that don't know, you start with five fingers. For everything you have done. If you have five fingers. RJ doesn't have five fingers. Oh, yeah, you do. Oh,
that matches my sign.
Stop, Top, and Talk logo. There we go. Can you start with five fingers?
Why is the stop, drop, and talk fingers so much fatter than the thumb?
We're not sure.
That logo together in about 6 minutes.
We traced
Does that Eva's person's hand have we, diabetes?
We traced Eva's hand like a turkey, and that's it.
They have a high sodium diet, Tyler. Piss off. All right. So
I start with five fingers.
She's very sensitive about her thumb.
So you start with five fingers. For everything you have done, I say never, ever have I ever, blah, blah, blah. If you've done it, you drop a finger. The last person with a finger up wins.
Wins.
Oh.
So it means whoever wins means they haven't done something.
Yeah. Prude.
Let's do it.
All right.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Never, ever have I ever given someone a fake name when asking for my number.
A fake name. I don't think I ever have.
RJ and I are like, and oh, B-Rock. Yeah. Cool. Okay.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wait a minute. Does Tyra O'Connell count?
Oh! Yes. Never ever have I ever gone streaking.
Yeah, I never done that.
No, I never streaked.
You guys are no fun.
But I do usually am naked at home.
Yeah, yeah. Especially when it's hot.
And hold my hand up.
Okay, so far we got four for me, four for Tyler, three for Brock, three for Eva. So you guys have obviously gone streaking.
Never, ever have I ever had sex in a public place.
Oh, God, no. I've definitely done that.
Brock, imagine if I was like...
Wait. Did you put your finger down if you haven't done it or if you have done it?
You have.
Oh, yeah. Man, my finger's going down.
Okay. Never, ever have I ever faked an orgasm.
Yeah, I think I have.
I have too, actually.
How does a dude fake an orgasm?
Oh, sorry.
Have you seen what's that movie, like MacGyver, where he's like...
Sorry, honey.
You have to push the fucking cow button. What is wrong with you?
sorry.
Oh, wait, I'm getting confused. Do I have two fingers left? Okay.
Yeah.
Apologize. That's how you fake orgasm.
Never, ever have I ever sent a dirty text to the wrong person.
I've never done that.
My mom.
Wow. Oh, my God. Are you serious?
Yep. Luckily, it wasn't that graphic.
Your boobs.
It wasn't a picture, and it wasn't that graphic. It was just like, I can't wait to, like... Oh, shit, Mom! I'm sorry!
Oh, my God.
Mom, did you just say Mom? Did you actually...
Yes, I sent a text to my mom by mistake once, and I was...
No, you didn't.
Time.
Oh. I'm uncomfortable.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Good night, everybody. I'm leaving now.
Wait a minute. So I mean that means you did you because it was the two people was it because the letter mom and something that started with M?
No, it was back. You know, I don't want to.
So you're texting. You're texting back and forth between two people.
Yeah, I don't want to age myself, but it was back when we had like the clamshells. Back when we just had the flip phones, you know. So
clamshells.
Not quite as you know. Yeah, for lack of a better word.
Oh.
All right. Never ever have I ever slept with someone whose name I do not know.
Yeah.
RJ's out.
I'm out. Sorry. I lose.
I love that B-Rock's finger of choice left up is the middle one.
It's my ET one, dude. Check it
never
out.
Never ever have I ever joined the Mile High Club.
Oh, no, I never have.
Can I start over?
No, you're what, out. You
have to, Mile High Club is you have to actually have sex.
In a airplane bathroom.
Like get a hand job or something. It has to be like sex.
Have you had a hand job on an airplane? Like
under the blanket?
Yeah, 100%.
Oh, yeah. Okay, good. Congratulations.
No, it doesn't count. It doesn't count.
You know what? The band and crew are on long flights sometimes over going overseas.
I'm going to do the pinky you know, as well.
Sometimes those flights get long, you know.
It gets lonely. It gets lonely out there on the road.
It's with your hand.
Oh, man.
Were you sitting next to Dave?
Never, ever have I ever dumped someone over text.
Oh, I've never done that.
Yeah. I have.
I win!
Hey! Congratulations, Eva is like the better than all of us.
I totally cheated because I had all the questions, fuckers.
You should have asked if you ever dumped someone over text and then they went crazy and you had to get a restraining order.
Oh! Okay. So, Trevor, one more thing.
You would have won!
One more thing before we're done with you. We played this game with another guest that we had. You go to Urban Dictionary. You type in the word dirty, followed by your name. Would you like to hear what yours is?
Yes.
Okay, it's thinking here. Hang on a second. All right.
Find out what that is, too.
Here we go.
A dirty Tyler.
Oh, boy.
To fart in one's hands and then slap someone else directly in the face. The object of a dirty Tyler is to do it quick enough so the slapped person can smell and taste it. Whoever loses the bet will receive 3 dirty Tylers.
Oh, my God. That's probably the best. That's the best one.
Wow.
That's the best one.
Wow. Hey, honey, that's what it's called.
Oh my God! Oh,
she was like, oh, what is this? And then I was like, I can't remember, but now I know it's a dirty Tyler.
Oh my God, I can't. Now I really can't wait to get back on tour.
I'm fucking crying.
Oh, that's funny.
Oh my God, that's great.
Tyler, you have been a fucking blast to have on the season finale of Stop, Drop, and Talk, by the way.
Yes! Thank you for being a part of it.
Yeah, thank you.
This show, guys, this show is just, it's god awful. RJ, I like how you have a guitar in the back there so people know you're a musician.
Exactly. Yeah.
Okay. So they're like, wait a minute, hold on a second.
The funny thing is I've got so many guitars in my house and I've got keyboards and synths and stuff like that. I have no drum set at all. Oh yeah. What do you got there? What's that?
Nice.
So what's that one?
What are you or something?
An SJ200. Elvis Presley gave it to me.
We've had 2 past guests this season do this. We've had Sully and Kobe do this. It's in your email. We want you to read us a little ditty called Goodnight Moon.
Oh, yes. We want the Canadian Sam Elliot with his leathery, velvety, chocolatey voice.
Goodnight Moon. I don't know what that is.
If you want to play guitar to it, bonus point.
That's a great idea.
Oh, that's awesome.
Can you strum a few chords while you sing, while you say, speak, while I can't talk.
You guys are putting
on. I don't even know what this song is, but you know what?
It's not a song. It's a children's lullaby book.
It's just a story. You just got to read it like a story.
But you know what I could do it in? What if I did it to the song of Ironic from Alanis Morissette?
Yes.
Ooh, that's not bad.
It's like
crank that bit.
Green room, there was a telephone and a red balloon.
Oh yes.
And a picture of
yes.
Oh, God, that great. Good.
Yeah, it's like
not a wedding.
Yeah. It's amazing.
That's a great song.
That would be awesome.
Those things are not ironic, are they? That's not a literal definition of irony.
Sitting on your chairs. And it is. What a lit. It's so good, though, right?
That was beautiful.
Not bad. That's not bad. That's the best one, right? I mean,
I think so. I think you're
you know,
right.
Probably do it too. In green. You could do it to Fast Cars as well, but. A cow jumping over the moon.
We need to tell our viewers to maybe look for that on your YouTube page after you perfect it.
Yeah, or you can go to my Facebook. It's tyraoconnell.org. Oh, wow.
Oh, my God.
Holy shit. I just opened it. Just open a can of worms with that picture. It's so good.
This is not helping. This is fucking hilarious. Anyway, thank you so much, Tyler, for joining us on the season finale, season one finale of Stop, Drop, and Talk.
Guys, I'm looking forward to season two and maybe even season three, guys.
I can't wait until season two when we can actually get a really big guest on. I mean, it will happen someday.
You know what? When I heard that I was the guest for the season finale, I was like, that's too bad that they're being canceled, but but I'll do it for $500,000. I will be
your Venmo's coming shortly.
He's already been paid, so we're good to go.
Yes. Oh, my Venmo. I just got the Venmo. Just came through. Thanks, guys.
That means you can leave.
Now he's had three fucking Venmos since he joined this Zoom call.
Thank you, Tyler.
Good shit.
He's $1.5 million richer. Good to see you, Tyler. Thank you so much.
Tyler, thank you so much. You're awesome. I can't wait to hang out again. I can't wait until we can have social non-distancing, social intertwining.
I think he's talking about sex, which is awkward.
I'm talking about a dirty Tyler.
I can't wait to dirty Tyler all of you.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Good shit. Take care. All right, guys. We'll see you real soon. Thank
Tyler,
you so
the man. Take care of yourself, man.
Right.
Love you.
It is now time for RJ's weekly rant.
Oh,
we haven't had this one in a couple weeks. I'm so excited.
It's time for an unnecessary rant. As soon as I find the button, where is it? Oh, here it is.
They're very unnecessary, so very unnecessary.
I got something to say!
Unnecessary rants with RJ.
And my unnecessary rants this week, real quick before we get into High Note and all that stuff, we just got to take a little break and we just got to rant about three things. Number one, my Ring camera goes off all the time. And I'm so paranoid of getting my house broken into. I'm like, someone's robbing me. Get the baseball bat. Oh, no. Oh, no. It's just the wind again blowing the tree branch. I hate that. Number two, how do all the mosquitoes find with pinpoint accuracy the exact places where my screens are compromised? Yet when I open the door to let the bugs out of my house, they're like, I don't know where to go. Where is it? Don't you want to be outside? I hate that. Number three, I canceled my gym membership and I've been trying to build a home gym so I can be safe, but I'm not able to find any home gym equipment online anywhere because everything is out of stock, out of stock, out of stock, out of stock. Come on, America.
Oh,
I thought we were all in this together. We're all here to get out of shape together. I'm doing my part. I'm trying to get out of shape for you. Why can't you do the same? Stop buying up all the home gym equipment so I can buy it. Anyway, that's my unnecessary rants for this week. I had something to say.
Nobody cares. You're an idiot.
Well, RJ, I don't think you're an idiot. I think those are real, true things to bitch about.
Thank you.
Because first world problems. Am I right? Am I right?
Those are my first world rants right there.
RJ, why can't you go outside and just do like some push-ups?
The bugs.
Lift some wood. Do some push-ups. Yeah. Like way back in the day, come on.
Oh, you know, I didn't think about that. Yeah, I probably should do that.
You guys,
right, I'm going to do that.
Had an incredible, incredible first season, and we have a couple people to thank, namely our producers, Dan Cattullo, Mark Lennon,
Mr. Direct.
Yeah, Mr. Direct. And of course, we have ended up in a bind or two before, and to our rescue has been
B-Rock's friend Wet Taco.
Yeah.
In the Tony episode where we got taken down mid-show because we aired part of their video that was approved by Sully. Mm-hmm. Facebook algorithms, though, am I right?
He helped us. He
and RJ worked together till, what was it, 2 a.m.?
5 o'clock in the morning.
What time?
Wow, really?
5 o'clock in the morning, getting that episode back up. Shit. Yeah, that's how dedicated we are. Brock was with me the whole time, man. Thanks, B-Rock.
Well, sorry.
Oh, no, you got kids. You got a family. We totally get it. So we got this, you know?
It's been a great adventure. I love all you guys. I'm so glad that we decided to do this.
Oh, my God. Everyone's been so helpful. Even my girl, Emily, helped me so much with the writing and figuring out what to say. I mean, every single week is like trying to get these episodes together. It's been such an incredible experience and such a great learning experience for all of us.
Yeah, really, true. Well, I know.
Oh, my God.
These guys have been great. Oh, come on, Dan.
Hey, Dan.
I always get told I look like that fucking guy.
It's not like, goodbye. It's see you later.
You guys did a great job this season. I'm really thank you for inviting me to do this with you guys, because it's definitely something to do over the past 10 weeks and keep me laughing every Friday night. So I really
thanks for coming on, dude.
Well, I think it's time to end this on a high note, you guys. Season 1. Let's do it.
It's our final high note, and I know with high note we like to keep everything positive. There's so much real things going on. Like it's we have to be realistic. But this high note, so we know that it's 4th of July tomorrow, and this week's high note is about how awesome America is.
America. Yeah!
Okay, look. I mean, all jokes aside, look. Like, for real, America really is awesome. Like, it really is great. I wouldn't want to live anywhere else. I've been all around the world, and I'll tell you, we have it good in this country in a lot of ways. But it's far from perfect. America is also great because we get to criticize it. And America needs a lot of constructive criticism right now. And it needs to be mature enough to leave its ego at the door. It's like we're all in a relationship with this country. And it's like being in a relationship with someone with a lot of severe social disorders. You know, you love her, you stand by her, you don't give up on her, but you don't just roll over and pretend everything's fine and dandy. You give her the respect of blunt honesty. Honey, you're obviously in a bad place right now, and I want you to get serious help because I want you to get better and put the whippets down. America, put the whippets down. Give me that can. That's not helping anything. Anyway.
Oh, my God.
Anyway, I want life to be better and easier for you and all of us, and I'll fight for you all the way. Now, isn't that the nicest thing you can do for someone you're so close to? Be honest and unapologetic. We can help America get better, but the fight needs to stay on target. We want it better for everyone, not just for a certain type or just the ones that look like us or just the ones who agree with us or share the same ideals. We need everyone to benefit and thrive, give everyone equal opportunity, even out the playing field, give those less privileged a fair chance, reduce bad decisions people make out of desperation. Also, we need more power to the people instead of just certain special people in power. Main theme of this high note: find the balance between fighting for what's right without taking it too far into the absurd level of cancel culture. And that just makes the side fighting for good look bad. Vote fuckers out. Don't go after Jenna Marbles and Billie Eilish. Come on, people. I think this whole rhetoric of more for me, less for you, great to be me, sucks to be you, also needs to go away. And remember what we learned in preschool. Share. Care about others. Be nice. This kindergarten bully playground insult world we live in right now is not working. Like, why is wearing a mask a political thing? Are we really politicizing hygiene? Wearing a mask is not a political protest in favor of more government control. Like, we hate freedom. Like, come on, get out of your fantasy world. It's as if these mask protesters are just afraid of being labeled some kindergarten insult. And if anything, it makes you the snowflake if all you have to complain about and bitch about is the slight inconvenience of wearing a mask covering up your COVID hole at the grocery store. Same reason you wash your hands after you take a shit. Nobody wants you touching the grocery store produce with your poo fingers. It just makes me think like back when they invented soap and they started putting it in bathrooms, were there a bunch of people protesting like, "Hey, keep your soap away from me. It's a free country. I don't wash my hands with soap. I wash my hands with this whole situation." That would have been their slogan. But anyway. Humans are naturally gross, so what's wrong with reducing the spread of gross when gross turns hazardous? Here's something else. Here's something else just to think about. Stop watching the news all day. Turn off the 24/7 cable news. That shit turns your brain into a caged squirrel, and the news is just a kid with a big stick banging on the squirrel cage all day. This is bad. This is wrong. They're trying to do this to you. They're trying to take that from you. Oh, my God. Instead of calling it the news, they should just call it the... Ah! Now, that being said, staying informed is important. You should get your news from legit sources with legit journalism in healthy doses. Like Stop, Drop, and Talk. But this 24/7 cable news is, it's bad for your brain. And don't take my word for it. Ask a therapist. They'll say the same thing. And if you don't have a therapist and you're watching 24/7 news, get a damn therapist. I've gone to visit loved ones, and I would wake up to them sitting on the couch glued to their shit-talking anger box. My anxiety levels would spike to the point where I wanted to put Xanax in my coffee, otherwise known as El Prezzo Latte. Yeah.
Oh, my Jesus.
Coffee's so chill, it doesn't even need ice.
Oh, my God.
A wise man once said, madness is like gravity. All it takes is a little push. We miss you, Heath. Well, the same goes for hate. Selfishness, racism, xenophobia, sexism, homophobia, white supremacy, abusive police force, distrust in science, distrust in journalism, cancel culture, and yes, fractured democracy. You know, I've been lucky to be immersed in many different cultures, and no matter what language, skin color, or ethnicity, it's plain to see we're all just people, you know? Unfortunately, we have a bad history of people in power dehumanizing people who are different to gain superiority and stoking fear into the followers to control thought. Others have used police force in the past to push their agenda and apparently still do. Feels like we didn't pay much attention in history class. It's like that other saying, those who don't learn from history are doomed to repeat it. Not sure who said that, but I'm sure it wasn't the Joker. Look, bottom line, even the three of us on this show, as tight as we are, we have a lot of things that we disagree on. But, you know, we have even more things that we do agree on. The simple things, being kind, compassionate, caring, empathetic, and wearing a mask in a public health pandemic. It doesn't make you a snowflake. It makes you decent and considerate. So don't let people slap labels on you and scare you into being a selfish asshole. Selfish assholes want more selfish assholes so they don't seem so asshole, you know?
Misery hey, loves company.
America, I love you. I love you enough to tell you when you're being an asshole sometimes, so don't be an asshole. You're better than that. So I don't care what side of the aisle you're on. I don't care whether you're blue or red or purple. Celebrate the 4th with at least the hope that more of us will see eye to eye. We have a lot of work ahead of us to get to decency, equality, better common sense. It's an easy thing to break and a hard thing to restore, but at least we have something worth fighting for. But pick and choose your battles wisely. It's going to be like eating an entire whale. So what do? We keep nibbling, one bite at a time. And I'm sure barbecue whale will be delicious this weekend. Be sure to try different sauces, spices, and marinades. Whale is going to be on the menu for a while. Let's get used to it. Let's get creative. Enjoy your blubber, everybody. Hope you like seafood. Remember to chew one bite at a time, people. It's time to wrap up the season one. Stay full of hope. We love you all so much. We're nothing. We are full of nothing but love.
I love you all. Love you.
And everybody, see you for season two of Stop, Drop, and Talk. Good night and see you soon. Stay tuned, everybody.
Stop, Drop, and Talk.